Hey everybody, welcome back to another video. This is Pooja and you're watching Ready Set Pooja. If you're new to the channel, thanks so much for stopping by, and if you're coming back, thanks so much for coming on back. Now, as you can see, today's video is going to be a little bit different from my normal videos. We are in New York City. I went there a couple weeks ago to visit some of my friends and decided to go and check out a few bookstores, so wanted to take you guys along on a little bookstore vlog. Of course, the first place we had to start was the Strand bookstore right off of Union Square. It's probably the most famous bookstore in New York, so had to inaugurate this vlog with a trip to the Strand, of course. We went in and just spent some time looking around at all the cool stuff that they have there. They have pretty much every genre imaginable. It's a huge bookstore with lots and lots of different things that you can go check out. I love that they keep it slightly messy. I'm not really sure if this is on purpose, but I really appreciate that they do that anyway, whether it's on purpose or not, because it really feels like you're perusing around this just giant collection of books looking for something that sparks your interest. So it's a lot of fun just to kind of wait around in all the different books, and you know, you see these ladders and stuff. I did find this copy of Clara and the Sun on sale, which in retrospect I really should have bought because it's usually not on sale in most places. But yeah, I didn't, so alas, that is a regret. And then we started walking in the direction of Soho because our plan in the afternoon that day was to go shopping for a bit. I wanted to go check out this bookstore called Dashwood Books that I'd never actually been to before, but I'd read it's a cool one just to check out, and it was on the way, so we decided to head in that direction, and we actually had some trouble finding it because it's sort of hidden away. It's like in the basement underneath another building, and there was a truck parked in front of it, so we just couldn't find it for a few minutes, but eventually we did, and we headed over here, and it was pretty cool. It actually turns out that Dashwood Books is more of like a photography bookstore, and there's a lot of things that you would expect to see as like coffee table books and stuff like that. So didn't actually end up buying anything as such, but it was a lot of fun just to spend some time here looking at the different books and pictures and all those different stuff that they had there. So that was a lot of fun. And then we headed out from there and kept walking towards our last stop, but we decided to take the long way and just appreciate all the different sights walking around New York, so I hope you enjoy them too. There's a cute dog over there. Oh, he's so cute. We saw some really cool street art, which is obviously a lot of fun and pretty unique to New York. It's just such a cool city and has so much character, which is really fun. As we were walking along the street just chatting, we also passed this cute little arrangement of plants. I don't really know if it was a store or someone's house or something, but I really like how the colors turned out on my phone camera, so here you go. There's also some dumpsters coming up shortly, so yeah, I guess that's just how life is, huh? And then we got a little hungry, even though we just had lunch like an hour before, and decided to stop and get a cupcake because this place said they were voted the best cupcake in America. I forgot the name of it, so you're just gonna have to take my word for it because it was a really good cupcake, and we got this red velvet one, yay, yummy, and shared it, and it was really, really nice. Then we headed across the street to McNally Jackson, which is, of course, another really famous chain of independent bookstores in New York. So of course, we had to include that in the vlog as well. So here's me walking over to McNally Jackson, and we decided to go inside. It's a little bit different from the Strand in that both the bookstores have tons and tons of books and huge collections, obviously all the popular books that are out right now, but McNally Jackson is just a little bit more organized, I would say, and so, you know, I don't really prefer one over the other, but they're just different in that way, and they had all these cool little sections and little nooks and corners of the bookstore, which is really fun to just go and hang out in. I saw a lot of books here that I've read recently being featured, and so it was nice to just chat about all those books with my friends who I was with. We were all giving each other recommendations, so now my TBR has grown even more, which is fantastic. But it was really nice. We also didn't realize there was an entire downstairs section for a long time, and then finally we did and spent some time checking out all the different YA and fantasy books that they have down there as well, which is great. Yeah, but it was overall just a really fun day. We walked around a lot, got really tired, got kind of dehydrated, and then definitely had to take a nap afterwards at one of my friend's apartments, but it was a lot of fun, and you know, I love visiting New York. Don't think I could ever live there, but it is a pretty fun place to visit, and this was a really fun, cute little bookstore vlog to make. So anyways, hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys at the next video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like this video, blah blah blah, leave a comment, you know the deal, and I will see you guys next time. Enjoy the last couple minutes of just checking out all the different books. All right. Bye-bye.